is a flipped class. So I assume that all of you have watched the video and the recording of this section, and also have studied the slides that I have uploaded in the Blackboard. So what we are going to do today is to practice, to solve some exercises and some old exam questions. And of course, we will revise also together what is this section about. But as I said, it is a flipped class. So I will not lecture here. I will not give you anything. Just we will solve and practice. So let me ask Mahmoud Al-Atiq. Yeah, Mahmoud, what is 6.5 is about, yeah, Mahmoud?
It's about the average and mean values. And there's only two rules for the whole section.
My question, Mahmoud, is about the average value of a function.
Of a function, yes.
The title of this section. Thank you, Mahmoud. Hamoud Al-Fawzan. Are you here, Mahmoud? Hamoud Al-Fawzan, can you hear me? Hamoud is absent. He's not responding. Muhammad Ismail, can you tell us, Muhammad, what is the average value of a function, how to find it?
Yes, it's 1 over b minus a multiplied by the integral of the function.
So you can say in words that if you have a continuous function over a closed interval, then its average will be the definite integral divided by the length of this interval. You are right, Muhammad. Thank you. Mm-hmm. This is the average value of the function, Shabab. It is just the definite integral divided by the upper limit minus the lower limit, by the length of the interval. Sufyan, what is the other part of this section?
It's about the mean value theorem of the integral.
The mean value theorem of integrals. What does it say, Sufyan?
In the indefinite interval, there is such as C, at least on C, equal the average of the integral of the function and the integral.
Excellent, Sufyan. I think I got what you meant. Abdulaziz, in every theorem, Abdulaziz Sibai, in every theorem, we have a condition and a conclusion. We have conditions and conclusion. So what are the conditions of the mean value theorem of integrals? Abdulaziz, the theorem says, the mean value theorem for integrals says what? If what, then what?
I'm sorry, doctor, but I forgot to revise.
What is the mean value theorem of integrals? Tell me what about it. What is it? The mean value theorem for integrals. What does it say? Okay, let me ask Ali Al-Ya'boub. Ya Ali. Ya Ali, when we have a theorem, Ya Ali Al-Ya'boub, if what, then what? Ali is not responding. Ziad Ishri.
Yes.
Yeah, Ziad, your name is now you change your name to be Saad, Zaid Saad. I don't know.
لا مو بان اللي سويت هو مشكلة في الجامعة كلمتهم غيرونه إلى الآن ما تغير.
No, it has been changed in Microsoft Teams, I think in Zoom, but it is still in the register website as it is in the portal. So I was wondering why you are absent last week, because your name has been changed. Anyway, Ziad, it is not our subject now. Let's talk about the mean value theorem of integrals. So what does it say? If what, then what?
Ziad? Wisho?
Muhammad Al-Wakil, let's go to Muhammad. Muhammad, what is the mean value theorem for integrals says, Muhammad?
محمد الوكيل دكتور
yes
if connect on a and b then there exists
if what يا محمد
if connect continue in on a and b
what is this I didn't understand what you meant by that
Here we can know the kind of متصله على الفتره.
If we have a function f that is continuous on closed interval a and b, then
yeah,
what?
That's what.
So this
I
is
mean.
The condition. This is the conditions of these of this theorem. Now, if this is the condition, what is the conclusion? Then what?
Then will be exist on this closed a and b.
Exist what?
بتكون يعني عن فترة A و B.
ها وبعدين.
And will equal the average.
What will be equal to the average? Abdullah عبد السلام يا عبد الله. Abdullah عبد السلام, can you clarify this more يا عبد الله?
Yes, if there is a continuous function between A and B. There is a C exist between these numbers such that F of C equal 1 over B minus A integral from A to B.
What is that? 1 over B minus A, the integral. So there exists a number between A and the average.
There is at least 1 F of C equal the average.
Yes, this is what I want you to say, Shabab. Yeah, Shabab, if you want to know that you understood something, you should be able to describe it in words. You can explain it to anyone, even if he's not special in mathematics. So if we have a continuation over closed interval, then there exists at least one number. Let's call it C. So there is a number between A and B. Let's call it C, for example, such that the value of the function at that number equals to the average of the function. What is the average of the function? We know from the previous rule, what is the average of the function? It is just the definite integral over the length of the interval that we are integrating on. In other words, if you multiply both sides by b minus a here, just if you multiply both sides by b minus a here, you will have this form for the main value theorem. And this is usually what we use, Yashaba. The main value theorem of integral says that the integral of a function from a to b, we can approximate it or evaluate it, if we don't know what is it exactly, to be just the value of the function at some number between a and b multiplied by b minus a. And I think this is very, very clear, yeah, why they call it the main value theorem here. It is, of course, similar to the main value theorem for derivatives, for the differentiable function and continuous functions. Let's practice by solving this. I think this is a recitation question. Hamad al-Dail, ya Hamad.
Yes, Mr.
What is the average of this function? What will we do?
First, we find the integral.
G average equals to what?
F of C multiplied by the length of the function.
No. We are asking about the average value of the function.
Average value. B minus A.
Here it is, yes. So it is
1 what? Over B minus A.
What is B minus A?
The length, the period from 0 to 2.
Here, in this exercise, what is it?
2 minus 0.
Minus 0. The integral from 0
to 2.
The function, which is x squared.
Yes.
Square root of 1 plus x cubed dx. Excellent. Thank you, Ahmed. Ahmed Suwaket, what to do next? Can you integrate, Ahmed?
Yes, teacher.
How to integrate this function? How to find this integral? So this is equals to 1 over 2 minus 0 is 2. The integral from 0 to 2, how to find this integral? How to integrate here? This is 5.5.
U equal 1 plus x cube.
Ahsant, ya Ahmed. Yes, you are right. So it is important, Shabab, to learn how to substitute. Yes, because I have noticed if you have a function of another function multiplied by the derivative of a function, if you wanted to substitute both u equals to g, not to the whole function, because it is important. This is the main idea of the substitution rule. So yes, here both this equals to u, not the whole integral or the whole function. So this is what we are going to, both equals to u. So thank you, Ahmed. Now let me ask Khalid Al-Harbi. Ya Khalid, if this is u, what we will do? So this is u equals 1 plus x cubed. So then what?
We differentiate.
Du, yes, du, we differentiate. What is du?
Equal 3x
dx
power 2 dx.
Dx, excellent. So in this
and,
case,
we will solve.
You can solve it for dx, or you can just notice that you have here dx and you have here x squared. Here they are. So you can just say that x squared dx equals to 1 over 3 du. Is that right? Or you can solve it for dx. So you will say that this is equals to du over 3x squared. It is up to you. You can use this or this. But I think you will save one step if you did this. Excellent, yeah, Khaled. Let me show you how. So we will say here, this is the integral of from 0 to 2. For this x squared, this is square root of, this is plus, of course, this is square root of u. And this x squared, dx, it is just 1 over 3 du. Is that right? Or, of course, you can do it like this, x squared, square root of u, and instead of dx, write du over 3x squared. Then you will come this x squared, and you will have this, the same as this. Okay? Is it clear, Khaled?
Yes, yes, yes.
Now, let me ask Turki Al-Atiri. Turki, what to do next? What is wrong with this, ya Khaled? Yeah, Turki. Turki, what is wrong with this? There is something wrong here.
I have to get the u values from x.
The limits, you mean the limits of integration, Shabab?
Yes.
This part is wrong. This is wrong. Because 0 and 2, they are x values, not u values. So in this case, we must here ask ourselves if
substitute by 0 and 2.
If x is 0, what will be u? And if x is 2, what will be u? So if x is
0, 1.
And if x is 2?
9.
9. So this integral here, these, the limits of the integral here, will be from 1 to 9.
Thank you.
It is, I think it is clear now. Okay. Now, from 1 to 9, this will be equal to what? Let me ask now Ahmed Abdul Mahsin. Yeah, Ahmed, are you with us? Ahmed Abdul Mahsin. Yalla, Ahmed. Speak up, Ahmed. Your mic is open. We cannot hear you. Ahmed, your mic is open, but you are not speaking. Ahmed is not responding. Let me ask Muhammad Al-Hindi. I know, yes. This is usually, yes, Muhammad Al-Hindi. What, yes. What we will do, Muhammad?
I will integrate.
So I know what we will do.
Yeah, u to the power of 1 over 2 plus 1.
I have here a half and here a third. What I will do?
1 over 6, you take it out.
This will be 1 over 2 times 1 over 3. The integral from 1 to 9 for u to the power?
1 over 2.
Du. Yes. So this is equals to what? 1, let me keep it as it is, Shabab, because it will be much easier. Now, what is the integral of u to the power half, ya Muhammad?
U to the power of 3 over 2 times 2 over 3.
Ahsant. From where to where? From 1 to
9.
From 1 to 9. This is very clear, Shabab. Now you will cancel this 2 with this 2, and you'll have 1 over 9 multiplied by you will substitute. It will be 9 to the power 3 over 2 minus 1 to the power 3 over 2. 1 to the power 3 over 2 is clearly 1. So this will be 1 over 9 multiplied by what is 9 to the power 3 over 2? Start with 9. 9 to the power half. 9 to the power half is 3. 3 to the power 3 is 27. Minus 1. So we will have 26 over 9. This is the average value of this function. So this means, ya shabab, by the mean value theorem, if you want to talk here about the mean value theorem, it means that there is a number between 0 and 2 such that the value of the function g, such that g at c, so we have here g at c equals to 26 over 9. What is c? C is some number between 0 and 2. Of course, here you are, you can find what is this c. If you integrate, you can just evaluate here. Both c here and solve it, you can evaluate it if you want. Okay, let's go to the next question. Here, this is a recitation question also. If f is continuous, so this satisfies the main value theorem for integrals, and its integral is given, we know what is the integral. So the integral from 1 to 3 is 8. Show that f takes on the value 4 at least once on this interval. What is this interval? It is the same interval that we integrate on. So how to solve this, yeah, Sultan Al-Mu'ammar? Sultan?
Sam, Doctor, موجود.
What should we do, Sultan?
Here we're using the mean value theorem, right?
Right.
طيب, we find a 1 over b minus a, the enclosed interval.
No, if you remember, the main value theorem for integral says that the integral, if the function is continuous on a and b, then the integral equals to f of c, where c here is a number between a and b. Multiplied, it will be f of c multiplied by b minus a. This is what this theorem says. So, yes, we'll just apply. So this will be equals to what?
Here, we write f of c times the 3 minus 1, right?
No, there exists c between 1 and 3 such that, this is what the main value theorem says, there exists c between 1 and 3 such that this integral equals to what? Who can tell me, Muhammad? Muhammad Al-Umari, Muhammad Al-Amri, can you tell me what is it, Muhammad?
Yes, Doctor.
Just apply this, ya Sultan, direct application. It will be equal to what, ya Muhammad?
Muhammad Al-Amri. F of C.
F of C multiplied by?
Multiplied B minus A.
What is B minus A?
Which is 2.
3 minus 1.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is what this theorem says. Exactly, we just applied the main value theorem, ya Sultan. So now this is what? 3 minus 3 minus 1 is 2. And what is the integral? It is given for me. I don't have the function, but I have the integral. So this is 8. Now, what is f of c?
4.
Divide both sides by 2. What do you have? 4. So did we solve this exercise or not? Did we show that f takes on the value 4 at least once in this interval? Yes, we show that there is a number between 1 and 3 such that the value of the function at that number equals to 4. And we have
a point.
So here we cannot find c, taban. We cannot always find what is this c, but we know that it is a number between 1 and 3. But what I'm sure about is that the value of the function at that number is 4, okay? So now, if I check now the main value theorem, it will say that if the integral of the function from 1 to 3 equals to f of c times 3 minus 1. So f of c is 4 times 3 minus 2 is 2. It will be 8. So this is, of course, satisfy the main value theorem. Great. The solution is here for you, by the way, Shabab, with details, of course.
Yes.
What about the time? We don't have much time, so I will try to solve this quickly, because we have also some old exam questions to solve. Let me ask Fadl Tawil, Fadl, to help me with this. Find the average value of the function, Shabab. How to find this, Fadl?
Yes, 1 over 3 minus 1.
The integral?
The integral of 1 over x from 1 to 3.
Allah yirda alayka Fadl. I know that you can solve it. Okay. Let me ask Fahad Suwaidan, ya Fahad. Yalla, continue, ya Fahad. How to solve this? It will be 1 over what, 2?
One over 2, and I will take the antiderivative.
Yeah, Fahad, what is the integral of 1 over x dx?
1 x
ln.
I'm asking
Fahad. Ln absolute value.
I'm asking Fahad, Allah yirda alayk.
Asif, tahmas.
Yeah, same. So this ln. Ln the absolute value of x from where to where? From 1 to 3.
1 to 3.
So it will be the half of ln 3 minus ln 1. This will be the half of ln 3 because ln 1 is 0. So it will be the half of ln 3. Okay? Now, let's solve part B. Munir Azab. Yeah, Munir. Munir,
yes.
Find C such that f of f equals to f of c.
Make f of c equal to.
You need to apply the mean value theorem. So yeah. Here,
make equal to half ln 3.
F of c equals to what? To half ln
3. F of c is 1 over x. 1 over C, sorry.
1 over C, Allah yirda alayk ya Munir, ahsant, yes, thank you. Muslim al-Hajji, yalla, how to solve this, ya Muslim? Salam, Muslim. Salam. Are you with us, ya Muslim, or you are not here? Salam al-Hajji. Salam al-Hajji is not responding, absent. Abdul Hakim Dajj. Abdul Hakim.
Yes, doctor.
Yalla, Abdul Hakim, what we will do to solve this?
Multiply C by take 1 over.
You can multiply, cross multiply, or take the reciprocal. So if you take the reciprocal of both sides, so this will be C equals to the reciprocal of this one. What it will be?
2 ln 3.
2 over ln 3. If you want to do this, you have 1 over C equals to ln 3 over 2. So this will be 2 equals to C ln 3. If you want C, just it will be 2 over ln 3. Okay? Thank you. Let's go now, ya shabab, to the next question. We did find C here. We were able to find C because we have F. Let's go to the next question. Muhammad al-Ghatani.
Yes.
The average value of this function on this interval is? How to find it, yeah, Muhammad?
First, we'll find 1 over B minus A. Which is B minus A, which is pi over 4, yes. And we integrate from.
It will be 4 over pi, by the way, in the next step. Okay.
And we integrate from 0 to pi over 4 from so the function, yes.
Okay. I know that you can integrate, Muhammad. So let me ask another student. How to integrate? No, please discard. I need to show it again. So if average here equals to 1 over pi over 4 minus 0, the integral from 0 to pi over 4 for 2 sine squared 4x dx. Okay. Now Abdurrazzaq Al-Anizi, Abdurrazzaq, how to find the integral of this integral? So this is equals to 4 over pi. 4 over pi for integral from 0 to pi over 4. Razak, are you with us?
Razak, yes. Energy. Yes.
Do you have an idea about how to find this? Let me ask you this question, Razak. What is the integral of sine squared x dx? Let me ask you another question, Razak. What is the integral of sine x?
Negative cosine.
This is negative cosine. Allah yirda alayk. Yes, you are right. So is this equals to cosine squared x or negative cosine squared x?
No.
So this is not true. Tayyip, is it equals to, as some of the your colleagues in the previous section said, is it sine cubed x over 3?
Yes.
No, it is not. Be careful. Be careful, it is not, ya shabab. The integral of u to the power n, if you have du, if you have du, it will be u to the power n plus 1 over n plus 1. Do we have here, do we have this? Do we have here d, d, d sine x? So this will be u squared du. Do we have this situation here? We don't have this situation, shabab. We don't have the function and its derivative. So if we have sine squared dx, what is d sine, by the way? What is d sine? What is d sine? D sine, so it will be the integral like this. D sine is what? Is cosine x dx. So if you have it like this, you are right. This will be sine cubed x over 3. Because this will be u squared. This is just will be the integral of u squared. And this will be u. If you bought u equals to sine x, this will be u squared and this will be du. And in this case, you can put it like u cubed over 3. So be careful, shabab, when you integrate. This is 5.5. You need to revise it very, very well. By the way, if you think that you are right, differentiate. If you differentiate this, impossible to have this. Impossible. Try that. So be careful. You can check that your answer is correct or not by integrating, by differentiating back. So Abdulrazak Al-Anizi, be careful, Abdulrazak. Abdullah Al-Muslim.
Yes.
Do you have an idea about how to integrate the integral of sine squared, this integral?
No, really.
Do you have an idea about it?
No.
Okay, let me ask Nawaf Al-Irani. Nawaf.
Yes.
Do you have an idea about this, Nawaf? Yes.
Maybe we change it to 1 plus cosine squared.
1 minus, you mean? Yes.
1 minus.
So we will use, ya shabab, this identity. Do you remember that sine squared theta equals to 1 minus cosine what, ya Nawaf? Cosine what?
Square theta.
What?
Square.
Two theta, be careful.
Oh.
It is the double angle identity, identity. So this two, we will keep it as it is, multiplied by 1 minus cosine what, ya Nawaf, here?
4x?
No.
8x.
8, the double.
8x
dx. Thank you. So here we are, ya shabab. So this is what we are going to do. So this will be equals to?
Doctor, can I use u equal sine square?
It will be, ya shabab, very bad idea. You tried in the, do you remember the quiz number 2? You did that. It will be very bad. What you will have if you bought that? It will be very bad idea. Because what will be du? Du will be 2 sine 4x multiplied by cosine 4x multiplied by 4. It is very complicated. It is not, you don't have there. These functions that you got here, you don't have them in the integral. When you use a substitution, you should make it easier. Even if you put it here equals to u. If you bought this equals to u, you don't have du. Du, you don't have it in the integral, ya shabab. We don't have here du.
Oh, okay.
Always, when you substitute, ask yourself, do you have du? Is du there? Is du inside the integral or not? Be careful, please, ya shabab. This is 5.5. I said to you, 5.5 is the most important section in chapter 5, in the whole course, by the way. Please, shabab, pay attention to that section. So let me continue now. Now we will simplify. And this yes, this
from where? With from this where did you get 8 cosine 8?
I don't ask me today. This is a flipped class. I'm asking you, shabab, today. Okay, you should ask yourself.
All right.
Yes. Let me continue. This is equals to 2 will be cancelled with 2. And we will have 4 over pi, the integral from 0 to pi over 4. After the class, shabab, if you have any question, 1 minus. Now, it will be, let me write it, no problem. So this will be 1 minus cosine 8x dx. Okay, now this will be equals to 4 pi. Let me ask Hussein now. It is your turn, Hussein. What is the integral of 1?
of pi over 4.
1 dx, what is the integral of 1 dx?
1.
What is the
integral? 1 multiply by...
I'm asking, answer this question. Forget about it. This question. What is the integral of 1 dx?
1.
If you differentiate 1, are you going to get 1?
No.
So?
It is x.
It is x. Allah yirda alayk, ya Hussein. It is x. Minus, what is the integral of cosine 8x? Thank you, Hussein. I will ask another student. Fida, ya Fida Shitti. Fida.
Wajud, doctor.
What is the integral of cosine 8x? Now, this is important. Unfortunately, we don't have much time. So this, let me ask you this question. What is the integral of cosine x dx?
Sine x.
It is sine x. Check. If you differentiate sine x, you will get cosine. Yes, you are right. So what about now if you have 8? If you have cosine 8x dx. Is it sine 8x?
No.
What
yes, yes, it is.
What it will be if it is not sine 8x?
Yes, it is. Sine 8x, yes.
Differentiate. If you differentiate this, if you take the derivative, are you going to have it?
Yes.
No. If we differentiate sine 8x, do you remember how to differentiate it? What will be the derivative?
Chepo.
The derivative is sine 8x, but multiplied by what?
Multiplied by 8.
So we have a missing 8 here. So in this case, ya Shabab, you can use substitution if you want. So one way is to use the substitution. I think it is good for you because you need to revise 5.5. So you can use substitution, ya Shabab. Let's take the substitution here. If we use the substitution for the integral, I'll talk now about the integral of 0 from, let me just mention this integral only, cosine 8x dx. So what we will do, we will put u equals to 8x. Du will be 8 dx, which means that dx will be du over 8. Now we will come to this integral, it will be cosine u, dx will be du over 8. So the 1 over 8 will be out. And we will have the integral of cosine u du, which will be 1 over 8. What is the integral of cosine u du? Look, we are talking about cosine u du. It will be sine u. And of course, u is what? U is 8x. So it will be 8x. So the answer now for the question that I asked you here, what is the integral? It is sine 8x, but you need to divide by 1 over 8. Divide by 8. To cancel out the 8 that will come when you differentiate. So you can do this, ya Shabab, after finishing 5.5, I don't think that you need to do all of these steps because it is clear. The integral of cosine 8x, when you have, ya Shabab, the integral of cosine, in general, if you have f of x dx and you know what is the integral of this, if you have here a of x, when you have a linear change, if you have a x plus b, something like this, the integral, if you have the antiderivative, it will be the antiderivative divided by 1 over 8, like here. So if you know what is it. So the linear change will not change the integral. So here we will have the integral of cosine 8. According to this substitution, it will be sine 8x, but divided by 1 over 8. Check. You can, ya Shabab, check your answer. Is it correct or not by taking the derivative? Differentiate this. Are you going to have cosine 8x? If you did, yes. So it will be from 0 to pi over 4. Now you know how to continue, ya Shabab. This is not difficult. Let me do it quickly because we need to practice more. Now this will be 1 over 8. Sine, multiply this by pi over 4. It will be 2 pi. Minus 0. Minus minus, it will be plus 1 over 8 sine 0. What is sine 0? Sine 0 is 0. Sine 2 pi is 0. So we will have what? Pi over 4 multiplied by pi over 4. So we will have 1 at the end. And the answer is 1. Okay. 5.5, Shabab, again and again. I will give you, Shabab, 2 minutes. 2 minutes or 3 minutes at most to solve this old exam question. Please take pen and paper and start solve. Let me launch polling for you. So you can share with us your answer. It is very easy question. It is just about the average value of the function. But here, of course, it is given in some way with a constant missing that you need to find the value of it. So you have a positive value here, B, or a positive number, B, such that the average of the value of the function on this interval is zero. Then what will be B? Yalla ya shabab.
دكتور من وين احصل قائمه الاجابات لان بالجوال تختلف حد عنده فكره طلعها على السريع
I don't know what you mean يا محمود what you are talking about
you gave me the options to choose one of them I can't find them
فوق عند شعار زوم في بول ان بروجرس اضغط عليها
اوكي
Okay, now continue, Shabab. MashaAllah, four students so far answered so far. But two of them only are right, and two are not. Continue, Shabab. One minute more. Twelve students answered so far. And mashallah, the majority of you, they got the right answer. Continue solving, ya shabab. I will share with you the results, but continue solving. I will end the polling and I'll share with you the results. So most of you, they choose C, and it is the right answer. The right answer is C. Okay. Why it is C? It is, of course, as I said, it is a very obvious question. So now what we are talking about here, we are talking about the average value of the function. So we have F average. We know that it is 1b minus a, the integral from a to b, f of x dx, okay? So now, what is b minus a? So here, a is zero, so it will be b minus zero. The integral is from zero to b for f of x. We have it here, we have f of x. It is b squared x minus x squared dx. This will be equals to 1 over b. What is f average, Shabab? Is zero, so this is zero. The integral from zero to b, we will integrate. Let me ask Muhammad Minayan, yeah, Muhammad Minayan, what is the integral of b squared? X and minus x squared. Muhammad Minayan, are you with us?
Yes, doctor.
Hello, Muhammad, what is the integral of b squared x?
it will be x to x to the power 2 over 2.
X to the power 2 over 2. What about b squared?
It will be b to the power 3 over 3.
Over 3. Allah alayk ya Muhammad. This is wrong. B here, what you are integrating with respect to ya Muhammad, this is d what? D what?
Dx.
Dx. So we integrate with respect to x. What is our variable? Our variable is? X. So B here is a constant. B squared is a constant. It is like 5, like 3, like whatever. It is a number. So when you integrate 5x, how to integrate this, ya Muhammad?
Only with x.
X squared over 2.
Yes.
So this is a constant. Keep it as it is. Keep it as it is, ya Shabab. It is a constant. Minus x squared is x cubed over 3. Thank you, Muhammad, from 0 to B. So now what we will do next, ya Shabab? Khalas, I think that you solved the question now. This will be 1 over B. The integral you will substitute by B. So it will be B squared. B to the power 2 over 2 minus B cubed over 3 minus 0 minus 0. This will be equals to 1 over B. It will be B to the power 4 over 2 minus B cubed over 3. So and B will be cancelled here. You can multiply both sides by B. This is equals to 0. So this is equals to B to the power 3 over 2 minus B squared over 3. This is equals to 3B cubed minus 2B squared over 6. This implies that 3b cubed minus 2b squared equals to 0, which means that b squared times b minus 2 or 3b. 3b minus 2 equals to 0. Impossible. This means that this is 0, b squared is 0, and this is impossible because b is greater than 0. Not only that, even if he didn't mention here, if b is 0, you will have 0 and 0, and the integral will be 0, and you have nothing. So in fact here, this means that 3b is zero. This is zero. So 3b minus 2 equals to zero. It means that b is 2 over 3. Now, ya Shabab, please get ready. I will stop sharing this. Please, ya Shabab, get ready. I will stop also recording. We will have now a semi-quiz, a short quiz. One